I saw a group called Mott the Hoople, who had a big hit at the time called Roll Away the Stone, and their support band was Queen. with, you know, Freddie Mercury doing the whole kind of double back, you know. I can always remember that concert. He was kind of knees on the floor, feet behind him, and his head on top of his feet and stuff. Yeah, so that kind of dates me somewhat. My name's Kelvin Thomson. I'm doing a PhD in composition at Royal Holloway. For many years, I've had a career as a professional piano player and music director. In the past, I've also played piano for Chuck Berry, the guy who wrote and does Johnny B. Goode that everybody does, and so on. Alongside my professional playing engagements, I've always tried to compose whenever possible. Often stimulated by poems. I think poetry probably appeals to me, I won't say the best, but what I like about it is that I can actually sculpt musical phrases from the rhythms of the words in the poem. It's particularly useful, I think, when one's writing for instruments that are effectively what I call voice instruments. So with the Fidelio Trio, the two voice instruments for me are the violin and the cello, which are, you know, the violin is like an instrumental version of a soprano singer, and the cello has this wonderful range where it can have the deep richness of a baritone or a bass voice, and it can certainly go really high as well. And I've sort of exploited that range and capacity for playing such a wide register in this piece, because it actually opens with the cello playing on its own, but really, really at the top end of the register. The piece that I've written for this trio project, Montage, actually started out as a response to a poem written by Robert Nichols, who fought in the First World War. It was a poem that I actually discovered last year when I was looking around for works to respond to the centenary of the First World War. Robert Nichols's poem, called Farewell, is in a collection of poems called The Muse in Arms, which was published in 1917. I initially set the poem as a song, and so Montage is, I suppose, an instrumental adaptation or rethinking of the first piece, which I called Farewell. This poem is called Farewell by Robert Nichols, and it's very important, as it provided a large amount of the inspiration for my piece called Montage. Farewell. For the last time, maybe, upon the knoll I stand. The eve is golden, languid, sad. Day, like a tragic actor, plays his role to the last whispered word and falls gold-clad. I, too, take leave of all I ever had. They shall not say I went with heavy heart. Heavy I am, but soon I shall be free. I love them all, but oh, I now depart, a little sadly, strangely, fearfully, as one who goes to try a mystery. The bell is sounding down in Dedham Vale. Be still, O bell, too often standing here, when all the air was tremulous, fine and pale. Thy golden note, so calm, so still, so clear. out of my stony heart has struck a tear. And now tears are not mine. I have release from all the former and the later pain. Like the mid-sea, I rock in boundless peace, soothed by the charity of the deep-sea rain. Calm rain, calm sea, calm found, long sought in vain. O bronzen pines, evening of gold and blue, steep mellow slope, brimmed twilight pools below, hushed trees, still veil dissolving in the dew. Farewell, farewell, there is no more to do. We have been happy, happy now I go. My piece, I called it Montage because it is a series of seven scenes, five of which relate to the Robert Nicoll poem, two of which are comments on, or let's say link or transition sections. One of the things that will be very different will be the level of the pizzicato section. Because unless you close mic that, the strings, you're not actually going to get that same effect. So I'll be interested to hear how the balance is there. And also, both Dara, the violinist, and Adi, you know, the most fabulous players. So their tone and the kind of individual timbre of proper instruments will just be very, very exciting to hear. I'm looking forward to for Tuesdays actually meeting the Fidelio Trio. I don't know them at all. I feel that I partly do from having listened to all the wonderful, or as many recordings that I could listen to. But I don't actually know them as people. So it's always an exciting time, I think, when a composer gets to meet the people that you've written the piece for. And also within this context, where it's in a sense in preparation for an unveiling of the piece, and not only just in a workshop context, but also within the context of a performance on the same day. So I think there's a sort of excitement, and there's also a hoping, as you know, composers always do, that you hope that firstly the trio like your piece, that they enjoy playing it, and you know, hopefully they'll be able to come up with some ideas or comments or things that might actually be useful. But it is also slightly nerve-wracking wondering how it's going to be. They've received the piece from me. The piece obviously lived with me for a long time before it got to them. And now, in a sense, it's kind of like I've handed the baby over to someone else to look after, and hopefully they're going to take care of it in the same way that I did. This section, sort of in the middle of the piece, where the piano really is featured playing a very gentle, mostly single line tune, is an example of how I've used the rhythm of the words to generate the melody. So, and now tears are not mine, which is the fourth verse of the poem. So the tune, and now tears are not mine, like that. And then with harmonies,